2011 Ultimate Builder Custom Bike Show in Washington, D.C. We're talking with Roy Chamberlin, and he's brought us a freestyle custom bike. Roy, give me a little about your background, please, sir.
We're with CNC Cycle. We've been around for 27 years. We're the largest shop in Maryland with 10,000 square feet. We do warranty work and service work on Harleys, Big Dogs, Saxon, Titans, Iron Horse, all the lookalikes. And we're an S&S Pro Tuning Center also.
Let's start from the beginning. What were you trying to accomplish with this build?
This was a Pro-Street design that we were doing for a customer. He wanted something low, sleek, and had some really nice lines to it.
What was the vision for this bike?
The vision was to have something that would be unique, as far as something that you're not going to see on the average market. So we did lots of little touches with the handlebars and fenders and things to make it truly a one-off motorcycle.
What was the inspiration on this?
Like I said, the customer originally that I had planned it for wanted something that he could show off, something that nobody else had.
Let's talk about the fabrication on this.
The fabrication, we made the handlebars where we Frenched in the speedometer, tachometer, and LED light system, which is by Dakota Digital. We made a strutless rear fender, so you see nothing supporting the fender. We've got the Datec chassis with a stealth-style swing arm and tricky air shocks. We also Frenched in our turn signals front and rear, and Frenched in the tag, and all our wiring is through the frame.
What about the engine on this?
The engine is a polished S&S 124 with a chrome cam cover and a polished S&S carburetor with a D&M air cleaner and intake system with Dyna ignition and Dyna coils.
How much time do you have devoted in the engine?
The engine, not a whole lot. We bought the engine assembled from S&S. All we did was polish the carburetor and chrome the cam cover.
I understand this bike is for sale, is that correct?
Yeah, this one's actually for sale. The customer that wanted it didn't have the money to finish it, so we finished the bike and now it's for sale. You could be the lucky winner.
Let's start at the front end. Let's talk a little about the front end on that.
The front end that we have here is a purse front fork assembly. It's a real nice system, which it looks like there's nothing holding the thing together. The fork tubes all seamlessly go together, and we have integrated our turn signals into the top triple tree system.
Now, as we move back to the tank, that was all hand fabricated, correct?
This was an independent tank that we modified to fit to this frame, to steel tank.
And now as we move towards the back, you discussed the strutless fender. What else about the suspension?
We did a strutless fender. You see nothing supporting the fender. Everything is made underneath the seat that supports it. And then we took the tank, the old tank that we got from Datec, and modified it so that it has a nice even seam all the way around the frame where it fits in, so it's very clean look.
Let's talk about paint.
This is Tangelo over Tangelo, so you have a light and a dark Tangelo color.
Did you shoot this in the shop?
We have a couple of different painters that we use. This one was done by Artistic Creations for us.
If someone would be interested in getting a hold of you at the shop or be interested in purchasing this bike, do you have a way for them to get a hold of you?
Yes, you can contact us through emails, which are info@candccycle.com.
That's candccycle.com.
Correct.
Roy, thank you very much.
Thank you.